Welcome to Stop Number 9 on the AVP Crocs Tour in Charleston, South Carolina. The AVP Crocs Tour heads to the Carolina Lowcountry for the first time ever. Charleston, South Carolina, where the Ashley and Cooper Rivers meet to form the Atlantic Ocean. And this weekend, the best beach volleyball players in the world gather here in Charleston for a chance at the title. It's the AVP Crocs Tour, stop number 9 at the Family Circle Tennis Center.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is Father's Day here in Charleston, South Carolina. The first time ever that the AVP Crocs Tour is here. How do you feel about that? And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. He grew up in Punahou High School, ladies and gentlemen, in Honolulu, Hawaii, on to Stanford University, a 1997 national champion, a two-time indoor Olympian, the 2004 MVP of the AVP, Lambo by day, but at night, Lamborghini! Lambo! And his partner, ladies and gentlemen, also Punahou High School in Honolulu, Hawaii, but he went to UCLA. Three national championships, 93, 95, and 96. A 2004 Olympian, a two-time Manhattan Beach Open winner, 14 Open wins. Give it up for one of the best all-around players in the world, Steino Metzger. Now it's time to meet the number one team on the AVP Crocs Tour. 5 of 8 wins already this year. Welcome back to the finals, gentlemen, because here we go. Out of the University of Central Florida, 15 Open wins, the most intimidating force in the entire world. Ladies and gentlemen, you must embrace the beast, Philip Dohauser. Embrace him. All right, ladies and gentlemen, his partner, over a span of a year and a half, he has 17 titles, giving him 27 wins for his career. Growing up in Santa Barbara, California, UCSB, the two-time All-American, and the reigning MVP of the AVP, your God of the Beach, the Professor Todd Rogers. T-Raj, ladies and gentlemen, stick around. I love you, Dad. We'll be right back.
AVP Crocs Tour Charleston Open is being brought to you by Crocs. New styles at Crocs.com. Bud Light, refreshingly smooth Bud Light, always worth it. And McDonald's. It's in the AVP. Is it in you, Gatorade? Oh, what a beautiful arena. The Family Circle Tennis Center. Charleston, South Carolina, the first ever visit for the AVP Crocs Tour, and it's time to navigate the match, brought to you by Nautica, Karch Karai.
Well, for Mike Lambert and Stein Metzger, Lambo on the line. Lambo has to cut down and clamp down on that Todd Rogers short line shot. Otherwise, Stein Metzger is not going to be able to play effective defense. And, of course, risk management means trying to control Phil Dahlhauser and his blocking and minimize the number of stuff blocks he gets. On the other side of the net, of course, Dahlhauser and Rogers. I got a scary view of this last night, playing against them on this hard pack court. Dahlhauser getting his pecs over the net and just roofing us. He's gonna be able to keep doing that because this is still a very hard pack court. And Dahlhauser is crushing the middle with his jump serve. As Adam Jewell said a couple of weeks ago, I've seen a lot of great jump servers, but I have never seen somebody hit down on the ball as it's going over the net. Then he mixes in the sidelines and it's scary.
Karchi pecs over the net. I like that one as we take a look at the rules of the game. Best two of three, ladies and gentlemen. First two games to 21 points. If we split and go to the rubber game, it's 15 points. It's a rally scoring system. Point every single play. You must win each game by 2 points. We are set and ready in Charleston, South Carolina. Big Mike Lambert at Punahou High School, Honolulu, Hawaii, Stanford University. I like to call him Mr. Perfect, the proud father of two. Wife Deborah at home with the kids, Costa Mesa, Mother Haysha, Father Vic on Father's Day, back in Hawaii. There's Stein Metzger, Todd Rogers, the MVP with 27 open wins. And there he is, the one we call the Thin Beans, Phil Dahlhauser. Some say the best in the world right now. 0-0 on the board, Lambo to serve. They go right at Dahlhauser. And Rogers, so good, taps that ball just by Lambo. I'm Chris McGee, filling in for Mike Goldberg, who's in Ireland working. Karch Karai, Dane Blanton, and Sinjin Smith. And Matty Boyce now taking over the MC duties, doing a phenomenal job. As Todd Rogers goes for the jumping from left to right. Steino buries it cross court, 1-1. We now go to our Bud Light recap.
Yeah, if you look at Lambert and Metzger, they went straight through the winner's bracket, first taking out Walkful and Scott Wong. They take care of them, 21-18, 21-10, and then Loomis and Stolfus. They went three, but took care of them, 15-11. And then they took out Gibb and Rosenthal, who are not in the final four for only the second time this year. And then in the semifinals, taking out Jennings and Williams. Of course, Williams, having that ankle sprain, played a big part in that match.
And, of course, for the other team, Dahlhauser and Rogers, very smooth going on Friday. Only played two matches. Nobody got but once to 19 against them. Then they dismantled us last night on that really hard pack
court. I see that score right there.
That was not a good one. And then today, a very close match. It was 14-all, but they break it open. Haydn and Keenan with a very strong third-place finish in this tournament.
Phil bombs it down the middle. Lambo takes it. And Lambo crushes it. 2-2.
And that's the exact serve that Dahlhauser's been working. When Lambert can control it, they're in great shape.
And now we take a look at the men's final results. Third place, Casey Jennings and Mark Williams, John Heiden and Brad King. We talked about the unbelievable effort by Mark Williams after spraining his ankle. Karch Karai and Kevin Wong in fifth with Jake Gibb and Sean Rosenthal. And in seventh place, Matt Furbinger and Sean Scott, Anthony Bedell and Fred Sousa. Lambo has to be effective with his serve today if they're going to have a chance against this team. And right there, he gets an ace the hard way, or as you like to say, Karchi, the lucky way.
You can even see him almost apologizing and shaking his head there. Dahlhauser does it two teams more than he has it done to him, so he probably deserves a few of those back. But those are the lucky aces that nobody really likes to see. That's the one negative of this rule called the let serve rule. The positive is when it bounces up high, it isn't a dead ball. We just play it out, and there are actually more balls in play as a result.
Lambo to serve. Raji on two. Nicely done. Tough for Lambo to get to the net after he jump serves that fast, Dane.
You know what? The surface is so fast, so they do have an advantage of getting up there. But usually that big guy who bombs a jump serve, it takes him a little bit longer to get to the net, and there you saw he wasn't there quick enough. But, wow, serving is going to play such a big part in this match.
Will Stein go on two? Yes, the pokey, nicely done, 4-3. Lambo and Stein lead. We stay and play.
I talked to Stein earlier, and that poke shot, he loves to do that. They're going to have to stop that pokey.
Safe to say bread and butter.
And if there's one guy, oh, my gosh, again, text over the net there. If there's one guy who can hang and swat that, it is Phil Dahlhauser. But that time, Stein switched the pass.
Coach Grime, I think your coach gave us a great message. Jana, Corey, and Christian, your family wish you a happy Father's Day, my friend. We got that word about he's running up.
Happy Father's Day to everybody. In fact, my dad and mom came out here, so happy Father's Day to everybody out there. Wonderful weather here. Beautiful Sunday to celebrate it.
Raji from the right side. Bill. Bill got it. Dane. You know, I think everyone around the country and around the world of beach volleyball wants to see, they really want to see Lambeau versus Phil, Stein versus Todd. They want to see these two teams in final.
They do, and the amazing thing is that they've only met once before, earlier in Miami this year, when Phil and Todd took care of business. So we all expected, especially after last year, being the 1-2 teams coming into 2007, that they would face each other, especially in finals, and this is the first final they're head-to-head.
I would have lost my house on that bet.
Dahlhauser serving. It's set by Lambeau. Stein right at Raji. Raji sends it long.
Very error there on that play. First of all, Dahlhauser did start Rogers as close to the net as he normally does. Normally he'll set that ball over him. But secondly, Rogers hitting out, he almost never misses on that, especially on this hard-packed surface here. You can see him. He's going to be a little off the net. Doesn't get quite the snap on it. You see there was very little topspin in that, so it sailed long. But he almost never misses that, and that's one of the reasons why it's so hard to beat this team.
Lambert to serve. Lambert turns it in the net. Mike Lambert, first victory. Was a win with Karch Karai at the Manhattan Beach Open in 2004. He was the MVP that year.
And he's had some great seasons since. Both these teams and many others really gearing up as Olympic qualification starts in this year, 2007.
Yeah. Metzger hammering down the line. One thing we talked to the coach about, Jeff Malagina, was one thing they worked on the last few weeks was not only the emotional thing, wanting to have fun and celebrating points, their ball control, their passing, because they were having opportunities, Karch, but they weren't taking care of business.
Yeah, they were, and they felt like they were addressing every technical issue, and yet they were still not making as many finals as they wanted. And so then they had to think, well, all we can do is just generate more emotion on every play, celebrate every play, have more passion.
And Phil gets up right there, Dana, just shoots it down the line. That is so tough to stop, especially you're digging in as a defender waiting for him to come with heat. He just taps it down the line.
Especially on this surface. Phil is getting up so high. And as you mentioned earlier, Karch, I probably saw you dig one of the most incredible digs last night.
Phil was
at the net with no block up, and he tried to hit it on the 3-foot line, and you stood in there and actually got it up. So it's a scary thought, especially if there's no one at the net when Phil Dahlhauser is hitting it.
I was hoping for at least one of those soft line shots, but you and I, you know, playing on these really hard courts, it affects the defenders. You can't dig your feet in, and you find yourself kind of turfing out. When you want to go left, your right foot slips, and it's actually harder to chase down those soft shots on this really hard packed court. It's hard packed because of so much rain they took here Wednesday.
And Phil buries it. So we're tied 7-7 here in game number one. It's just a back-and-forth battle between two of the best teams in the world here in Charleston, South Carolina. Take a look at Big Phil. We call him the Thin Beast, and that is why. Take a look at the Expo camera. That's a burial.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. The AVP Crocs Tour, Charleston, South Carolina Open. I'm Chris McGee, along with the greatest of all time, Karch Kerai. And Karch, we'll start with Phil Dahlhauser and Todd Rogers. You had success against them. You actually beat them in Tampa. How can you beat this team?
Well, watch what we did last night and do the opposite, because we got crushed by them. They are playing really great volleyball right now. One thing you do is you try to go at Todd Rogers. If you don't get points on him, you try Dahlhauser. But he was absolutely overpowering, practically knocking my head off. Lambert can be a bigger factor at the net. He might be able to get Dahlhauser a little bit.
And now we bring in the other broadcast member on this team, the gold medalist from 2000, Dane Blanton. Dane, you've had a chance to watch Mike Lambert and Stein Metzger all weekend. They're back in the final for the second straight week. What are they doing right? What are they doing wrong?
Well, Metzger and Lambert didn't start off the league year that healthy, but they got back on track, and they started getting out there. I talked to them. They said they were a little bit complacent. They'd go out there and expect to win matches. And as Karch said earlier, they're technically strong. They just have to bring the fire, the desire, the passion. They have to go out there and fight each and every point, or it's not going to be easy. You know, it's gotten tougher since 2006, and they know it.
Great stuff, Dame. Now we're going to bring in the fourth member of our broadcast team, Mr. Sinjin Smith, with a SolarSafe weather conditions report. Sinjin.
Thank you, Geeter. Solar safe conditions. Well, here we go. Let's start with our air temperature. It's a little bit over 80 degrees. There is some cloud cover, so every once in a while it cools off just a little bit. Our sand temperature, not that hot because we had so much rain on Friday. And Karch mentioned that's why we have kind of hard-packed sand, and it's easier to jump out here. Now, look at our UV index. 7. That's pretty high. And when it gets to be that high, all our pros out here wear sunscreen, so you should too. Now, back up to you, Geeter.
Thanks, Sinjin Smith. And I got to tell you, Karch, Dane, it dumped rain all during the week, but Saturday and Sunday, it has been absolutely gorgeous. Our night session that most of you probably caught on AVP.com, Mosaic yesterday, it was perfect conditions.
Well, we have tried a number of new sites this year. This is my favorite. Beautiful. Got a lot of grass here, trees, shade for the fans. The only thing it was, the courts got soaked.
You know, I'm starting to think, Dane, that if you had a drought in your city, call ADP, we'll come, it'll rain, and then we'll leave.
It seems like it has rained so much here. But like you said, Karch, if we're not on the beach, this is the perfect setting. The green grass, the trees in Charleston, the hospitality has been unbelievable.
And a lot of potential here at the Family Circle Tennis Center.
And you mentioned it. We solved the drought in Tampa a couple of weeks ago.
We sure
so
did.
We're just solving drought problems all over the country here.
Stein Metzger, they're leading 8-7. Steiner with a jump serve, and it's just long, so 8-8 on the board. You know, you looked at that one stat earlier in the game, 13-1 in finals for Phil and Todd. That is remarkable.
It's an unbelievable record, and they have not lost in a final in 2007. So Stein and Lambert have their work cut out for them if they're going to take them down in the final.
Phil Dahlhauser, 15 open wins already. He just started playing a few years ago. Didn't play organized volleyball until he played club volleyball at the University of Central Florida. Stein Metzger. Hammering cross court. Phil on his horse. He's got it. Lambo's going to move Stein over and take it. And Raji's shot goes in the net. Great rally. 9-8. Lambert Metzger.
Boy, I'm wondering where those were last night. That's twice now Rogers has had point scoring opportunities off great digs and hit the ball out of bounds. One was long and one was into the net. It was like he was looking too long at the defense and the ball blew back a little bit. Watch here. He takes a nice look. Looks a little there. And then it's so far behind him, he can't get the ball over the net. He's thinking, oh my gosh, I lost out on a great opportunity after two digs in one rally.
With a 418 hitting percentage this year, that's down from 459 last year. So maybe a few more errors out of Todd Rogers this year, but the team as a whole looks much stronger.
And Dane, anybody have better vision right now on the AVP Tour than Todd Rogers?
No, definitely not. The guy who used to have the best vision, I thought, in the world was Zamarco, who we played in the finals of the 2000 Olympics in Sydney, Australia. But Todd Rogers sees everything. If you take just a 6-inch step, he sees it and he goes the other way. So you have to have that discipline and wait him out in the middle of the court. That's the only way you're going to dig him.
Metzger off the quick set.
And to add to that, with this hard pack, that is even harder to do, to have that discipline, hold your ground, and explode, because you just don't have as good a footing to do it in. You can't dig your feet in as much. See here, Stein Metzger slipping it. Oh, my gosh, armpits over the net by Dahlhauser, slipping it under.
They, Lambert and Metzger, have been doing a great job of neutralizing Dahlhauser so far. That's the way they're going to win this match, keeping his blocks down to a minimum.
You said it, Karch, and right now, something we usually don't see, even at 10-9, Phil Dahlhauser with no blocks in the game. Oh, that ball just out, a rare error.
Wow, that might be the story of this final. Big Mike Lambert is up, and he's causing fits for Todd Rogers there. We've seen three errors by Rogers already, something we never see.
And, Dane, you and I were sitting together last night at the night match when they beat Jay Gibb and Sean Rosenthal. Mike Lambert looking like 2004, 2005 Mike Lambert. I mean, he had the fire, and he was all over the place.
Right, you remember those days, Karch.
I do, and Rogers with another out hit. But Lambert was just burying balls last night. It was amazing. They got off to a slow start, just like they did a week ago on a Saturday night in Atlanta. Came back to win the next two against Gibb and Rosenthal.
I'd have to say this is the hardest surface that I've ever played on because of the torrential downpour. It is so hard, but it's making for some spectacular volleyball.
Yeah, you guys might have been watching Dahlhauser hit a ball like that 2.5-foot line almost to end our match last night. It was scary. Another out hit. That's five now for Rogers.
You know, that wrist-away shot is really his bread and butter, so for it to be going wide around, even though it's just inches, is rare.
Yeah, I talked to Phil, and they want to go to Todd Rogers, but they're not afraid of the thin beast. He says if it doesn't work on Todd, they'll go to Phil. But it's obviously working. Todd just missing the lines by 6 inches each time.
You know, you see Lambeau make that early move with his feet into the angle, giving Todd that line, making him think a little bit.
So important for a blocker to get up early and in the face of the attacker. Then the attacker has to make the decision. If you're late going up there, Todd will use you all day long.
Stein Metzger and Mike Lambert, after losing in the first round in Huntington Beach to Vinnie Robbins, they bounced back and won the tournament. And then they were in the final again last week in Atlanta, losing to Jake Gibb and Sean Rosenthal.
You don't see Phil and Todd in this situation often against lesser teams sometimes, and they play lax and kind of get right into it, but they cannot take this team lightly at all. Look at that serve just on the back line and out. If that goes in, the momentum is really in the favor of Metzger and Lambert.
TV crew just on their game. Good work. Steino on two. Got it. Steino. Acrobatic Stein Metzger.
That's three times this match we've seen a tough jump serve, but either twice for Rogers and now once for Metzger, saving. Look at Dahlhauser is hitting that ball down from the 26-foot line, but Metzger saves it. Both teams having close passes, but doing a great job. And what happens is, as you talked about before, Chris, the server doesn't have enough time to get up there and put up a well-placed block.
Surfing paying off right there. Steino landing and dropping it under the net. Like dropping it backside. Nicely done. Raji.
Rogers.
Cross-court shot. Good.
Laser-like shot. Cross-court.
Yeah. Rogers just slipping it by that Lambert block. Lambeau turning it on last night in that semifinals. No stuff so far today.
That kind of looked like last night. What were you thinking, Karch, when that ball was coming at you? I mean, I thought you needed a helmet, but you just hung in there and you dug it underhand.
I just was happy my insurance was all up to date.
Stein Metzger from the left side. Cross-court shot. Good for the point. 15-11 here in game number one.
And earlier this season, Metzger wasn't siding out with this consistency and with this authority, but he has really brought his game around. They had some inconsistent finishes, but they're back, I think, to the form they wanted to be starting in this season of 07.
Lambeau off the top of Phil Dahlhauser, earning a point, 16-11.
I talked to Phil earlier before the match, and he said after these 2 weeks that they had off, finishing third, they want to get back on track. Here you see in the replay, Phil up and over. They want to play at a higher level than they've been playing. They've been a little lazy, they said, after having so many wins, and they want to go overseas with some momentum. You know, they want to really push through, and they're not happy about the last 2 weeks.
Oh.
Bowser, that quick wrist snap cross court.
It's nice when a drought is two-thirds and they're hungry to be back in the finals. Yeah.
There it is, Phil Dahlhauser. He got it. We'll be back in a moment, 16-12.
I am here in the Crocs Lounge, courtside, with Jake Gibb. Jake has won the last two events. You only missed two finals. It's got to be weird sitting here watching the finals.
Tell you what, it's not fun, that's for sure. I want to be out there, but both these teams are great teams and are playing great.
Yeah. Now, you lost to Lambert and Metzger in this event. What happened during that event?
Well, I'll tell you what, we smashed them the first game, they smashed us the second game, and then we had a battle, and Lambo came up big. He got a couple key blocks on us and pulled it out.
Okay. Phil and Todd are basically kind of dominating, but you guys have had more success against them than anybody else. What is it that you guys can do against them to win?
Well, our success rate isn't that great, to be honest.
Better than anyone else, though.
Yeah, we'll take it. But, they're such a difficult team because Raji's so good at seeing the block. So you have to go really late and get over the net really quick against him or he just eats you up.
If you look at the score here, it's 16-13, Metzger and Lambert are winning. What's going on? Why are they doing so well right now against them?
Well, I think it comes down to Raji hit a couple balls out. You know, he doesn't do that often, but he's settled down and is playing great. Like, you know, he's the MVP for a reason.
And I think serving helps, too. You've got to put pressure with the serve. Is that what you guys do when you play against Phil and Todd?
Yeah, you know, you always feel a little pressure going against a guy like Phil because he just bombs his jump serve. So you try not to force it too much. But, always try and keep pressure on him and, see if you can get some points that way.
Now, Spiker, I didn't realize when they called you Spiker that was actually your name. What's going on with that?
Well, it's my mother's maiden name, so I have a grandma Spiker. How good is that?
That's unbelievable. I thought maybe because there's so many kids in your family, they ran out of names, and they got to call you something, right, in volleyball. But they probably didn't know you were going to be a superstar volleyball player when you grew up.
You know, my parents want nothing to do with volleyball. They didn't at the time. But, I think four of my brothers have Spiker as the middle name. So,
family name.
But you're the only one that took advantage of it, right?
Right, exactly.
All right, back up to you, Geeter, from the Crocs Lounge with Jake Gibb.
Thanks, Sinjin. Jake Gibb, not just one of the greatest players in the world, but one of the greatest guys from Bountiful, Utah. Thanks for stopping by the AVP Crocs Lounge. We saw an ace earlier by Phil Dahlhauser, number 100 for him. And then we see one by Todd Rogers on the jump float. And it hits the line. Steino lets it go. And just like that, guys, they're back in the ball game at 15 facing 17.
Big side out here for Metzger Lambert if they want to pull away and win this game. Ooh, that one almost fell.
Big Phil gets that right paw up and over. 16-17, and when Stein and Lambeau have faltered in some of these tournaments, it's because their passing is broken down.
And nothing you can really do about that one Dahlhauser serve down the middle. But Metzger letting that second ball go, and this one, he's trying to cut it so tight it never even goes over the net. Again, we saw Rogers missing some plays he never misses. Now Metzger misses a play he never misses.
Big paw of Darth Dahlhauser right there, kind of frightened Steino. And gentlemen, once 16-12, now 17-17.
That's amazing that they have allowed this to happen. But Phil and Todd are putting a ton of pressure on them. You know, I talked to Stein, and he says he can't poke the ball. He's got to come out more aggressive. And you've seen a few pokies here. It's because of what you said earlier, Karch. The passing isn't right on.
17-17 here in game number one. We play it to 21. They go to the quick set, and Phil clamps it, 18-17.
Well, I know that one took a few off my noggin last night. What Lambert and Metzger were trying to do there, he said, quick, quick, watch how fast that set goes out. He's trying to make Dahlhauser beat him laterally, but Dahlhauser all over that ball, piking over with his right hand and his left. Watch how quickly Dahlhauser gets over to his right and takes that away.
I like that a lot. They're trying to move Phil around. They're running a little bit of a quick set. That time it doesn't work, but you have to do something. With Phil on this surface, it is frightening at the net. You have to move him around and somehow get him off balance.
Phil and Todd on a 5-0 run. Once down 17-13, they now lead. And Skyo needed that one to the coffin corner. Tickling the tape, 18-18.
I think he tickled the buckle between the two lines there, perfectly placed, and that was about the only thing that was open on the whole court. Sometimes Dahlhauser and Rogers will leave you that little court to hit at, right on the ring.
You can't hit the corner any better than that.
And one thing you don't want to do is aim for it every time, because half the time it's going to be out of bounds. You've got to give yourself a little margin of safety.
It's time Metzger to serve. 3 national championships at UCLA. Chance for the point. Lambeau's got it. You heard Stein say, sit.
A little bit of a pokey out of Lambert there. I'm sure Stein taught him how to do that. It's funny, Stein does that shot so often that I've been in practice before, and people throw out the shot and they say, Steino. But Stein gives his credit to Angino, actually, who taught him the pokey back in the day.
Angino, Eduardo Basil, one of the coaches now here on tour. And he said last week he went over 1 million pokies. Now, do you think Stein said ouch when he set the ball, helped the ref make that call?
I'm sure it did. That was a very, very tight call by the referee, and I'll tell you one thing, he will have his hands full the rest of the match by calling it that tight.
But I don't see Rogers arguing it a lot, and that's usually the sign. He meant it to go closer. It's hard to see on a replay, really hard to see when a referee calls a double hit contact, but now we're at game point.
So a very rare setting error by Phil Dahlhauser gives Lambert and Metzger game point, game number one. The Charleston fans on their feet here in South Carolina. On the AVP Crocs Tour 2007. Steino to serve for the game. And Raji delivers for 19 points.
I'll tell you what, if Stein and Lambeau pull this off, they know that they've dodged a major bullet. By letting them get 5 in a row, it would have been devastating for them to lose this first game.
And you could see Lambert hanging his head earlier, but they've picked it back up, and now they have their opportunity. They get to receive, serve, and win the game. What we call a side-out finish of the game. Now.
So, here we go. Game point. By Rogers, then Metzger, 21-19. Stein and Lambeau. Lambo take game one.
I don't think Lambo even touched that ball, and that was wise of him not to, because they thought it was going to go deeper, and then all of a sudden he swings and misses. What a dig by Rogers here. And, of course, Metzger chasing it back down to watch. Lambert fanning it. They think it's going deep. It doesn't.
What a finish. Game number one. Stick around. Game two coming up. Metzger-Lambert lead. Beautiful Rainbow Row, the historical Charleston, South Carolina city, where the Cooper and Ashley Rivers meet to form the Atlantic Ocean, and the kids and the ladies and the men are having a good time here in Charleston, South Carolina. What a game number one. There's Phil Dahlhauser bombing, and then on game point, game one, Lambo and Stein come up huge. Chris McGee along with Karch Karai and Dane Blanton.
And don't we have another first today? First time a play-by-play announcer does the PA, sprints right up to the booth, and he's ready to go.
I wasn't going to say it, but I think the first time in any professional sport, yes.
Don't kid yourself, yes. Chris. You did the same thing in Dallas.
Just sprinting up here, sweating, running over people. It was nice.
Got to get a little sandy and sweaty. It's a beach volleyball tournament.
It's been a lot of fun. Mike Goldberg in Ireland, so I get a chance to do the play-by-play. Matt Boyes doing the MC, and to be here with you guys, phenomenal on Father's Day.
Wow.
Ball handling error by Lambo.
After a great game one win to come out that flat, amazing. The story of game one, I thought, besides the switches of momentum, was Rogers' 5 or 6 hitting errors. Don't expect that this second time around. If you're the team on the other side of the net, you know you're going to have to work even harder to beat that great Dahlhauser-Rogers team.
You talked about errors. Todd Rogers had 5 in the first game. Metzger with heavy heat, 1-1. And you know, both these teams will be going overseas. We can take a look at their travel schedule. They got France, Norway, Jersey, back to Germany, then to SoCal.
Well, Metzger earlier was talking, and Lambert were talking about how this is a huge 6 weeks for all the American men, all the American women. Many of the big points Olympic qualification tournaments accumulate in these 6 weeks. So that's why everybody's been gearing up so hard. And I think we've got a great contingent of men and women, a really deep field, probably the best representatives we've had in a long time.
Rogers from downtown.
Lambo drops, but he can't come up with a dig. 2-1 on the board. Karch, I want to ask you this. You played with Mike Lambert for 04 and part of 05. You talked about him maybe hanging his head. What did you used to say to him when he would kind of get down on himself?
Well, I'd just say, look, and anything went wrong, it was my fault. And you just go be a big blocker and be a great setter for me and a tough server. I'll take all the blame if things go wrong. And he was just so fun to play with because being so young, he's not that young age-wise in early 30s, but he was young as far as a beach volleyball player. And to have that kind of youth really inspired me and gave, kind of rejuvenated me.
3-1 on the board, and both you guys having a pretty good weekend. Dane Blanton playing for the first time with Paul Baxter, taking a ninth-place finish. Karch Karai, you were one win away from another Final Four. You guys came up short. You finished fifth. And Dane, I know it was exciting for you to be back out here. Took a couple weeks off.
Absolutely, and like I said, what a great venue to play at.
Great saving set by Lambo, but Phil is there for the block. So 4-1, guys, here at the start. The momentum that Rogers and Dahlhauser needed.
You know what? They did dodge a bullet, Lambert and Stein, at the end of that first game, and they come out a bit flat. We've seen some lazy passing errors, and here Stein just kind of comes in and tries to beat Phil on the angle. Kind of a half-speed shot. We saw him come out with so much fire early in game one, and they can't get complacent. That's what they talked about prior to this match. They have to have the fire. They have to have the desire to win each and every point.
There's Phil leading many statistical categories.
And on that last play, it was almost like Metzger thought, that ball can't get blocked. Only Dahlhauser is going to block that shot. He was surprised that it did get touched. Most blockers won't touch that one, and Dahlhauser will at 2.2 blocks per game. And the leading blocker on tour.
Best blocker in the world, Karch?
I say so at this point, although I haven't seen a lot of the European and Brazilian competition, but just from what I've seen here, he is amazing.
It's going to be very interesting when he gets face-to-face with guys that look just like him, 6'10", 6'9", some of the European players.
Trouble.
Mike Lambert, looks like Todd Rogers arguing about four contacts.
I didn't see a touch from over the game, sir.
Todd was arguing that Lambert touched the ball earlier in that rally and calling for a four-hit contact, but it actually went over, so Lambert and Metzger had three hits to get the ball back over the net.
Big 2 points for Lambo and Metzger. They get it to 4-3. And here we are, game two. We'll be back in just a moment. 4-3, Rogers Dahlhauser lead. Lambo crushes it home. Welcome back to the Charleston, South Carolina Open, the 2007 Crocs Cup standings. Here are the men's leaders through eight events. Phil and Todd, number one, but barely over Gibb and Rosenthal, took a fifth this weekend. Lambert and Metzger in the third spot. Olsen and Ring still at four. They had a second place finish in Hermosa Beach. Jennings and Williams climbing up after a third. And in sixth, Matt Furbringer and Sean Scott. And there he is in seventh, Karch Karai and Kevin Wong. And in eighth, Fritz Sousa and Anthony Medel.
And what a match yesterday after Mark Williams hurt his ankle. He continues to play with Casey Jennings in a thriller, beating Medel and Sousa after getting a medical timeout, getting it taped, and Casey Jennings coming up to the net to block a few times. Wild match, got the center court crowd going.
Cross Cup leaders will be receiving served, and Raji puts it down the line and out of bounds. So another error for Rogers.
I guess you got to have Mike Lambert at the net to get Todd Rogers to hit that shot out. I've never seen him miss so many of those in just a game and a quarter now.
Yeah, he might have that many errors in a tournament or two, but not in one match. So something's going on with Todd Rogers. He's just not as focused as he usually is. Or maybe it's Mike Lambert in his face there. He's just trying to go around Mike Lambert. That ball's out of bounds. And those are the ones that don't make the stat book for Mike Lambert as a block, but it's an error for the other team.
And it's that same shot, guys, about four times, missing just by an inch. Let's see if he goes to it again. He does that time perfect. And, guys, I think we all just expect him because every single time he steps on the floor, he's almost perfect with his shots.
And that's why he earned the MVP in 2006. He was clearly the MVP player. This year, I think if we had to have early voting, it'd probably be to Phil Dahlhauser. But Rogers has been really solid, and that's why they have won so many tournaments and made so many finals this year.
Metzger challenges the block of Phil Dahlhauser. Successful 5-5.
Got a little lucky, though. Split the uprights for the field goal on that one. If the uprights were not a little spread out, and let's see if we can see it. It'll be harder, a little harder to see from the side.
Did you go Dahlhauser a little
right
there,
between. Karching? That's the one where sometimes Dahlhauser would take it off his noggin. Look at that. Right through. And that's a scary needle to try and thread because 9 times out of 10, it's coming back.
Raji, great shot. You know, we talked to Phil about that yesterday in the AVP.com Crocs Lounge, and he said he gets hit probably more than anybody, maybe in the world, off his dome. And Dane, he doesn't like it. You don't want to get the thin beast angry.
No, you don't. And a few years ago, he had a nice bandage on there, and I think Karch might have hit it up for a second time, and I'm not sure if he got stitches or not, but that big forehead right there, when he's getting over the net, is a target.
You got to just tell him he's jumping too high.
Yeah. Maybe that's the only way to take him out.
Yeah. And guys, you take a look at Phil's jump serve. He's absolutely, it's like we are in a tennis center, and I feel like he's serving a tennis ball.
And you can see how hard packed this surface is. The crew has been working day and night to try to make it as playable as it can, but it's about as hard as we've ever had. It's been so wet, but Dahlhauser is getting up so high.
Chance for Lambert to Metzger to take the lead. Lambo is stuffed by Dahlhauser.
Two big guys going at it at the net. That was a stuff down, and a play like that can give Phil a lot of momentum. You got to watch out for those huge stuff blocks. Look at how high both these players are, up and over. Perfect block, perfect form, jetting over the net, Phil Dahlhauser.
It's like watching two huge guys from the indoor teams battling it out at the Olympics.
Unbelievable.
7-6 here in game two. Lambert Metzger leading 1-0. 21-19 victory in game one. Steiner with that late chisel down the line. Nicely played.
And it was interesting because last week in the Atlanta final, it was the Battle of the Titans. Jake Gibb is getting every serve, the big guy on Gibb Rosenthal. Lambert getting every serve. Now it's the battle of the smaller players, Metzger and Todd Rogers getting most of the serves and carrying the load.
I think on this surface, it's just too scary to serve the guys that are 6'6", 6'7", that are also athletic because they're just thundering the ball each and every time. Hopefully you can get a dig with the shooter.
Roger that time with that wrist away shot, and it's good by about 6 inches.
He's missing it by 6 inches to 2 feet. That time he threads the needle there. And Lambert wants to lure him in. You can see Lambert here. At the last second, he jumps to his left. But it's a little, he's even reaching left. But look, he moved his left hand back away from that and missed out on the block.
For all you young volleyball players out there, that's how you do it if you're a right side attacker. That wrist away shot. Todd makes it look so easy. Lambo learning from last time when Phil stuffed and goes off speed, Karchi, with a little cutty Sark on the rocks.
You don't get to see Lambo on the left much and then going the cut shot. I would expect him to go the high line, and that's what Rogers was thinking, and as he runs over there, nice cover. Lambert using the block to get the ball back, and then the cut shot. Rogers anticipating the opposite.
So we're all tied up at 8-8. Stein Metzger, 34 years of age. Olympian in 2004 with Dax Holden, took a fifth-place finish. Team of the year in 05 with Jake Gibb. Raji.
Looks like Raji has calibrated his arm swing. Those are precise, and they're just in the court. As we saw in the first game, they were just outside of the court. That is a very difficult shot to hit, and you've seen him do it twice now. Just seeing the alley and going down the line, and that's why Todd Rogers is so good. He is so precise, and there's no question that he was the MVP last year.
Stein Metzger, heated up for 9-9.
And if he hadn't had those calibration problems, they probably would have won game one, and that would then force Lambert and Metzger to adjust. I think one of the keys to beating Dahlhauser and Rogers is taking away that line shot when he has it calibrated right and hitting it in the court.
There's the beautiful Emily Metzger, Steino's wife, doing a little text message back home. Probably to Bill and Melody Metzger in Hawaii.
Don't Stein's need to do parents. It as much now with the AVP.com, with the mosaic. Everybody's watching.
You're so right, Karchi.
In fact, Mike Lambert is talking about how his dad, Vic, and a lot of the players, they have family watching, friends, and saying, what were you thinking on that play? Why didn't you hit angle? Why didn't you dig the line on that? Everybody's giving us advice now. It's pretty funny.
You can see us and hear us all the time. Frightening. AVP.com, and it's been so great. The night matches last night, people were watching and text messaging and just loving it. I mean, it's a beautiful thing.
Yeah, the friends and family are just loving it. They don't have to go to every tournament to watch everybody.
Ooh, just long.
We talked about that serve down the middle. Phil loves to line up in the middle of the court and serve it straight down the middle. And what he does by doing that, he forces the opposition to pinch inside, and then he starts pinging the right and left sideline. So he's got a lot of weapons when he goes up to serve. And that let serve rule has been really good for him because he hits it with such a downward trajectory, it sometimes just dribbles over.
Phil to the line. 11-10, Phil Dahlhauser and Todd Rogers leading over Mike Lambert and Stein Metzger here in game number two. Steino and Lambo leading 1-0. And right now, Stein Metzger, we appreciate him stopping by with Sinjin. Sinjin.
Okay, Steino, you won that first one. Sweet. You're right there. You can take him in two. I know you don't want to go to three. What do you have to do to close it out?
Well, I feel like we're siding out well. It's just a side-out battle right now. And Raji's finally settled down, and he's found his rhythm. So you saw we tried to mix one into Phil. Right now we're just trying to crack him. And maybe look to see us tighten up our serve and go for it a little more.
Okay, good luck. Back to you, Geeter.
Appreciate that, Stein Metzger, Sinjin Smith. Stick around. We got a classic brewing in Charleston, South Carolina. Time for the Jose Cuervo AVP flashback. Mm-hmm. Back to action, Charleston, South Carolina, inside the Family Circle Tennis Center. Chris McGee, Karch Karai, Dane Blanton, and Sinjin Smith. We are in the finals. Todd Rogers, Phil Dahlhauser, Stein Metzger, Mike Lambert. Steino to swing.
Yes!
And he puts it away, and we're tied up at 11 here in game two.
I love to see what Stein Metzger's doing. He knows Phil's big, and he knows Todd's a great defender, so he's blasting that angle as hard as he can, but then every once in a while, he's challenging Phil's block, and he's been coming up with gold, just weaseling it through, getting it through the uprights as he did earlier. He knows the defensive set. He knows they're great, but he's challenging them, and you got to love seeing that.
Stein Metzger and Mike Lambert, five wins in 2006, the Crocs Cup champs, one win in 07, that's Huntington Beach. Last week in the finals in Atlanta. So 19 times, guys, these guys have been in Final Fours. Consistent all year long last year. And that's why it was so shocking this year that they weren't in the Final Four of the week.
And it left some players scratching their heads. How does a team that gets five wins wins the Crocs Cup, but a team that gets eight wins doesn't? And it's a question of some tournaments are worth more than others. Yep. And Lambert and Metzger were big when it counted most.
That's service error number six for Phil Dahlhauser to one ace. So that's unusual for Dick Phil.
We talk about the consistency of Metzger and Lambert, 14 of 14 semifinals last year. And this year, they've only been to five. And amazingly, this is only the second consecutive weekend in a row that they've pulled off semifinal appearances.
They finished in 17th in Dallas and a ninth place finish. Very unusual finishes for the Crocs Cup winners.
Beautiful set by Phil, and Lambo's there. They're saying four contacts, no touch by Mike Lambert.
But he had it sealed off, and that's why it was hit into the net, because Rogers had nowhere to go on this. Watch how far Lambert gets over. Whoa, he's just cutting off. The closer he can get his hands to the ball, the less angles that Todd Rogers has to hit at. Think of the hands as like against a flashlight, and the closer they get to that ball, the bigger a shadow he'll project onto the court, taking away those angles.
That's the real Hawaiian curtain right there, Mike Lambert. Lambert and Stein going up together in Hawaii. Bringing that 808 fire they've been looking for. There's a nice pokey by Rogers. People know how difficult that shot is, Dane?
Now, to control the poke shot is so hard. I don't use it unless it's an emergency. Here you see he doesn't know where to go. The block's sealing it, so he knuckle pokes it deep and with control, and Todd Rogers definitely has that shot.
That's because out here on the beach carts, you can't open hand tip. Indoors, you can't.
That's right, and Rogers is the master at saving the close set. Almost anybody else gets blocked on that
block. 13 kills and 9 digs for Raji. Steino listening to Lambert, goes with the cut shot, and it's good. 14-13.
And that time, Rogers was trying to play a little cat and mouse. He went over really early to dig the line shot, challenging Metzger to hit the soft angle. He responded with his first soft cut shot over Dahlhauser. You can see, look at how early Rogers is over there. He knows Metzger is going to see that, but what he's hoping is that Metzger will hit it low and Dahlhauser will block that ball, like we saw earlier this game when Metzger was surprised at that shot getting blocked.
Come on, stop!
Oh, the jumbo just over the hands of Phil Dahlhauser.
What a great shot right there. Seems like Todd Rogers is having some trouble. We talk how great a setter Phil Dahlhauser is, but he's pulling him inside. It's on Todd's left shoulder, so he's having so much trouble seeing the court, and he's having to resort to these desperation shots.
And it's getting a little too close. If anything, on this hard surface, Dahlhauser should be keeping him too far off, maybe 6, 7, 8, 9 feet off, instead of 6 inches off, where Lambert can smother that ball, and all he has a choice of is the knuckle.
Right, and inside and tight is the worst set for a right-sider, and he's got a few of those sets, as you said, too tight for blockers of this caliber.
I don't know if you guys caught that X-mel right there. Let's not underrate Steino's set off the dig right there. It was incredible.
Unreal.
So Phil, 6 service errors, Todd, 7 hitting errors here in the finals. You just don't expect to see that. These guys are 13-1 and in the AVP final. Right now, backs up against the wall. Oh, Steino, things are just going their way, Dane.
They are absolutely going their way. Up 16-13 now with some spectacular plays and they're getting the breaks. When you have these great rallies and great plays, when they go your way, you're feeling really good about yourself. Here you see him just dig in the angle. Perfect dig. Well, perfect would have been on his side of the net, but he'll take that. They didn't have to expend any energy. It goes in and it's a point.
He looked like Karchi last night when he was playing them, just sitting in the pocket, digging in.
And now we're at the same point as game one where Lambert Metzger yep. had a four-point lead at 16-12. See if they can close it out without giving up four or five in a row.
Oh, Karch the computer dating back to game number one when Lambert and Metzger led 17-13 like they do right now. And that's going to be a timeout for Rogers and Dahlhauser. Let's take a look at the floaty ace.
You never see Rogers let that go. Oh, and look at how close that is. But it hit. The mark is out. But when it hits the line and moves it like that, that is in. Rogers broke the golden rule. If it's close, you play the ball. If you don't know, you play it.
4-0 run for Lambeau and Metzger. They lead 17-13.
And in game one, Dahlhauser Rogers responded with that 5-0 run.
And Karchi Dane, everybody out there, let's take a look at the AVP Cuervo flashback. We're talking 1996. Santa Cruz Open. Rob Hyder and Troy Tanner taking on Jose Loyola and Adam Johnson. And right now you're going to see the 88 gold medalist Troy Tanner all chiseled up, bombing it from the right side, but it would not be enough because Adam Johnson, AJ, Karch's former partner, hitting the jumpy, and Jose delivering the gold, the Jose Cuervo gold for 100 G.
Jose, pre-hip surgery, rising and crushing that ball. That was one of the last Cuervos until they came back this year, or back last year with the Triple Crown.
Amazing to see Jose Loyola up there. Some people forget how good, how athletic, and how dynamic he was. He's still such a great player, but he's just not as explosive. Unreal to take a look back at that Cuervo shot. Wow.
Fantastic. Crowd's having a great time. Matty Boyce, the MC, singing a little Sweet Caroline Neil Diamond style right now. People enjoying it.
And now there's a huge side out for Dahlhauser Rogers if they want to have any trouble winning this game.
You said it, Karch, and you are correct. Raji from the right side. Stein Metzger.
They've got the fire that you were talking about. They want to have that fire. That was the missing ingredient. They realize there are so many hungry teams on this tour. They have to bring it every single time. And Metzger is so good. He and Sean Rosenthal are just absolutely amazing at chasing down those soft shots. Then he brings the heat to close it out.
If you look at the body language out there, shoulder slumped over for Phil Dahlhauser and Todd Rogers, and the momentum is all on the side of Metzger and Lambert.
Rogers trying to end the 5-0 run, and he does, and they needed that. It is emergency time, 14-18.
And that time, Lambert trying to slip his right hand in there, but Rogers just getting it right underneath his wrist. Now a big side out for Lambert Metzger to maintain that 5-point lead.
This is exactly what Phil and Todd did not want to do. They've had two off weekends. They wanted to get the momentum here, come in strong, show some emotion. Phil says, you know, we're not emotional players, but we got to play with more emotion. And now they're slumping their shoulders. The body language does not look good.
You know, great job by Lambeau to pull right there. The set was a little bit off the net. Phil tried to put up a great ball in transition, but that is a huge, huge break for Lambeau and Stein.
You got to give it to Stein. He's going at it. He's blasting balls. He knows Todd's there, but he's challenging Todd to dig that ball. He's hitting it as hard as he can.
And he knows he has Dahlhauser right in front of him, too.
And you know, you guys talk about the big guys on the surface. Well, this surface favors Stein Metzger as well.
Yeah, it favors anyone who's athletic. You're playing almost on an indoor surface that's so hard, but Stein is definitely taking advantage of it.
Raji. Got it. 15-19.
If you look at the two little guys, as you said, the shorter guys on the court are Stein Metzger and Todd Rogers. Stein is a lot more aggressive, whereas Rogers is coming in, trying to give the smooth shot down the line, and Stein's actually eating that shot up. So I think we need to see more aggressive play out of Todd if they're going to get back in this game.
Talk about the heights. Stein Metzger, 6'3". Mike Lambert, 6'6". to the cut shot. They switch sides, and it is game match. Championship point, the first ever professional beach volleyball event, the ABP Tour in Charleston, South Carolina, and Lambert and Metzger on the verge of title number two in 07.
Something we've never seen all year possibly here. Rogers and Dalhauser may lose in a final. This would be amazing.
They are 13-1 until today. They're now down by 5 points. Mike Lambert, victory number two on Father's Day in Charleston, South Carolina.
And not winning for the third week in a row for Dalhauser Rogers. Big surprise.
That wasn't just a victory. That was a very decisive victory. They took it to them there. They came out with a game plan, and they just really put the pressure on them. I don't think Dalhauser and Rogers have ever seen a team put the pressure on them.
And Rogers goes up, and Lambert and Metzger making a statement here on the AVP Crocs Tour. There's Emily Stein's wife. She's going nuts. And there it is. They hug it out. Jeff Alzina, the coach. Metzger and Lambert, the winners.
AVP Crocs Tour Charleston Open has been brought to you by Bud Light. Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it. Crocs. New styles at crocs.com. And by Nautica. Navigate life. And as always, the AVP Tour reminds you to vive responsibly.
Time for the Xbox 360 play of the match. This would be game point in game number one. Stein would deliver. Raji there with the dig. And then here we go. Look at that layout by Stein. The little back flipper for Lambo. And that is it. Game one, 21-19 would go to Lambo Stein. And they are down with Sinjin Smith from the Gatorade Champions Interview. Sinjin.
Okay, I'm here with the champions, Mike Lambert, Stein Metzger. Second victory this season, and you did it over the big guys. How does it feel?
It feels good. I think, we might have caught them on a day when they probably weren't on their top of their game. So, it came to the scores kind of are, you know, I expected a bigger battle than that, but it was, we'll take it anytime we can get it, especially against those guys.
Hey, you're nuts. You guys put so much pressure on them, you at the block, you at the defense. They just couldn't do anything. What's going on? I mean, how did you guys pull it together for this event?
Well, you know, Sinjin, sometimes you'll come out and you'll feel like crap and you just end up playing unbelievably well, and some days it just doesn't go for you. And today was our day, and we were just feeling from the get-go, and we just pushed and pushed, and we could just taste it from the beginning, and we just rolled.
Well, you guys were flawless. Congratulations, our champions.
Happy Father's Day.
What a weekend here in Charleston, South Carolina. This concludes our coverage of the AVP Crocs Tour Charleston Open. We're once again in the men's final. Mike Lambert and Stein Metzger defeated Phil Dahlhauser and Todd Rogers by the score of 2-0. For Dane Blanton, Karch Karai, and Sinjin Smith, I'm Chris McGee. So long from Charleston, South Carolina. You've been watching the AVP Tour.